Thank you for doing this. What was the inspiration for Cellfish?
For Cellfish in particular?
Yeah. What was the inspiration?
You know, the inspiration was honestly the question. I was asking myself the question. I was asking myself the question of like that moment that I kind of like come to, I could consider some arguments in old relationships that I had had where they were trying to convince me that I was selfish. And, you know, in the process of somebody telling you that you're selfish, you never accept that you're selfish. And then I started with the journey of self-inquiry and really zooming out and being able to look at myself as before the body. And from there, I was able to see kind of like how I've been as the body. And then I started asking myself the question, like, why won't I admit that I'm selfish? Why won't I tell the truth? And that was it. That's the inspiration for that, is me asking me. Kind of like just, you know, putting myself in, under like an investigation, in so to speak, you know. Yes, it does. Yes, it does. And I feel that honestly, the question, you know, they used to call me question mark Mattie when I was growing up, because I've always had a question. Question mark Mattie is what my mom and them used to call me growing up, you know, like she always got a question. And it's true, because I feel that the question has always been there, the wanting to know, the wanting to realize. And what seems to be happening is that the question is not as present anymore, as much as the resolve of there's no need for questions or answers. It's more just kind of like a stillness of just what is, you know what I mean? And, you know, because at first there's a lot of questions, you know, when you start to, I don't know, just start to turn over in yourself. You start to ask questions, a lot of questions. And I think I've been asking them since I was a kid. And now asking these questions, these deeper questions, just like one question has led me to this one, and that question has led me to that one. And that question has led me to this question, which is this final space within myself. And I feel like it's within all of us, is the space of like no questions anymore.
Yeah. I was curious, so why choose music as the portal for that, that exploration?
I don't think that I did, honestly. You know, I feel that it kind of, it just happened that way. I used to be conflicted between hair and music. And I was literally like, and I was going crazy trying to figure out which one I should do, because, you know, that's a part of the program, right? That's a part of the thing out here, is it's like, you got to find something to do. You got to figure out what you're going to do. And if you don't know, then something's wrong with you. So I always felt conflicted, like choosing. And it was like a while before it really just kind of sprung
wait,
up.
Why conflicted? I don't understand.
Because I was like, I need to do one or the other. I need to commit to hair and not do music. And then I need to commit to music and not do hair. And it was just like, I don't know what to do. You know, like it was kind of like this, a little bit of a pull in me. It feels like it's very much of a flow right now, but it hasn't always been that way. And I feel that it was when I just said, you know what, fuck it. I'm not choosing nothing. I'm just going to create. I want to create. And music has always been in my life. You know, it's always been there, but it wasn't until, I wanted to start having a different conversation is when the art kind of came into play. And like, I was like, how am I gonna tell this story? These stories that are starting to come to me. When I started writing, I wrote my first song, New Love. And the way songs come to me is they kind of come in story form. And so I wrote the song and I'm like, but now what is it going to look like? So then I started to expand into like the visual component of how the show looks and like how the visuals should feel like, you know? And so it's just been a natural thing of how like it happened in music, but I really feel that the music is medicine, and medicine is really what's a big part of my life. It shows up in music. It shows up in hair. It shows up in conversations like this, you know, it's just there. I think all of what we're seeing right now is an aspect or component of the identity. And that would be, you know, something that's very natural for me to create with like color and expression. Free flow, you know, like this kind of, there's a water element that kind of goes through, I think, of a lot of the work, that it feels like watery, it feels like flow. I do really feel like it has a lot to do with an aspect of myself that I'm observing too, you know, and I'm watching.
So is this new to you as well?
It is, honestly, because I can see where throughout the life I've always been this one, you know, in different ways, you know what I mean? But this is showing up very new. This is the very first time, you know, somebody asked me, am I gonna do like tours? And I'm like, yeah, that would be super dope. Like, I want to see who's interested in talking about the same shit. Like, I'm down, but there's no proof of concept, you know, like it hasn't been done before. And so this is all kind of showing up in me, and then I'm giving it out. And it's dope to, I think, watch and to use it, you know, create synergy around this conversation of who am I, you know, and this deeper inquiry into ourselves. So, yeah.
Is it... You're in Texas, yeah?
Mm-hmm. I'm in Dallas.
In Dallas?
Yeah.
What kind of social environment is Dallas? what is going on in Dallas?
Seriously, do not. Oh man, don't sleep on Dallas though. You know, Dallas, we go like way back when it comes to like having dope people from Texas, you know. Like we go
Erykah Badu's from there, yeah?
Yeah, we go into Erykah Badu, we go into Janis Joplin, we go into Jamie Foxx, we go into Kelly Clarkson, we go into like Snarky Puppy, Sean Martin, we go into Daniel Jones. Yeah, we go into like a lot of dope ass people, Kirk Franklin, you know. So I really feel like I just have been around them and for so long, and kind of like just admiring everything that, you know, Dallas people be putting on, but my shit's always just been different. to just keep it like a whole stack with you. It's just always been a different sound. And I feel like for a few years, like I've been just waiting, you know, for the ears to kind of like be ready for this. And I just kept singing it. And so we're still singing it. just excited. But yeah, Dallas has got a scene, and it's really kind of like a slow burn. It's not a firecracker city, like, you know, you're gonna pop off real quick. You'll be here doing it for a while, but it's a lot of good shit that comes out of Dallas, Texas in general. So yeah. But I kind of create a scene at my house, though. I like to be at home. I like, you know, getting with the tribe and doing ancestral medicine. That's life for me.
What does that mean?
So I am actually really like a home, like create the community in the backyard type. Get the drums going, you know, pull out the psilocybin, the plant medicine, you know, the ancestral ceremonies that we do. Sometimes we create an atmosphere for people to journey within themselves and create family around it. And those are the people that I really love spending time with, because I know we're talking about, you know, wanting to know more, wanting to go deeper within ourselves. So it just appeals to me, you know. But I'm always down for a good art show. Dallas got some good art shows. But as far as like, you know, just environment, for the most part, I like to be at home amongst the medicine. I think it just, I honestly feel like it didn't, for me and Taffy, it's been really, really natural from meeting to, you know, choosing the right time to work together, to giving him a track that kind of like, I think, started the vibe of the EP, and him turning it into like what you hear for Human Thing. And then just going into more of his tracks and writing to them for Jupiter's First. It's all been really organic, and I'm super thankful. It's been so natural. So yeah, I think the words just met the melodies, to be real with you. Like his story that he tells with his music, it's ridiculous. Like, yeah, yeah. So whenever I'm around good music like that, it just pulls on me to want to write or sing or something. And so this is like the first time that I've ever really felt this fucking in unison when it came to like finishing a project, starting a project from the beginning, doing the middle process, and then finishing it out with a creative partner like that. So it's pretty, I'm super thankful. I'm super thankful.
Does he have the same philosophy and spiritual understanding and desire as you do?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I feel that Black Taffy has a very broad sense of knowing when it comes to everything. And I think that's really what it really boils down to, is really like working with those that have like this broader spectrum that happens inside of them, so that whatever they approach it with that, and it is what it's supposed to be. And I feel that like no matter what he would approach sound wise, he'd be able to really like go in and kind of master it, and really like find out where the pieces of the puzzle should go and put them together from that space. And I feel that that's where I operate from too. So to answer your question, I'm going to say yes, because that's the central space that we both create from. And I think, you know, there are a lot of different, probably smaller like fractions within that we could kind of break that equation down to. that would probably say, oh no, he doesn't believe that and I believe this. But, you know, I don't really feel like that's the thing I would focus on. I would really focus on, like, we come from the same central place within us, and it meets in the lyrics, and it meets in the melodies, and so does Tremaine when it comes to visual component. So
yeah. What is the so the EP's out?
The EP is.
What is the goal at this time? Is it just to tour? Is it just to try to get more people to listen to it? Do you know what I mean? Like,
what, I do.
What is your everyday like now?
Yeah, I feel like for me, the goal is to come to a space within myself that I don't have no goal for it, honestly, that I'm just surrendering to, like, what it wants to do. The music itself, I feel like, wants to be present here saying this, and I'm willing. I'm like, okay, let's go. I literally am just like, I'm along for the ride in the most grounded, aware sense possible. Does that make sense?
Yeah, it makes a lot of sense.
Yeah, not flighty, not, you know, not being blown by the wind here for the ride. Not like that. But I mean, like, I'm allowing so to the point that I'm here for that ride, but I'm also grounded in the knowing. And I'm very clear on what my mission is in life, which is to know myself, to remember myself fully before the body. And I feel like other humans want to too, that this music is going to remind them of that. And they're going to be like, damn, she's saying what I want to say. she's saying what I want to say. And that we meet up at shows and festivals and concerts, and we just do that, you know? And we meet up in medicine circles and life. So that's really that feels to me to be the communication from the music, that's what it wants, and I'm down.
Essentially, you had this idea in your head and you brought it to life, right? So you brought something from the inside world and you brought it out, and it's in the world and it's been received so well, and it's pleasing a lot of people. Is there a wow moment? Have you had a wow moment? And if so, what does it feel like?
I don't even know how to describe it.
Or is this a day in the life of Mattie? I do this shit every day. What? Manifest shit.
No, you know, honestly, I honestly am like really just, I'm happy. I'm really happy is what it feels like. It feels like happy.
I don't see it, Mattie. I don't see the smiles, Mattie. You're not.
I'm happy, but I'm not like, it's not like I feel like, oh my God, we've arrived. You know what I mean? It's not that feeling. It's more like that I just kind of feel like I want to stay empty. I want to just be like very thankful, and I want to just keep saying what wants to be said. You know what I mean? Because I know that there's other things that are coming to me now to write. So I really am just wanting to stay like with it. I want to stay with the writing, with the saying, you know. So I spend time going like, give thanks. I talk to my dad, my ancestors all the time about like what's happening with me. And one thing that they told me was that you're not there to be anybody else. You're there to talk to them about who they think they are. And that's really the conversation. And if I'm having that conversation, you know, it feels like, it feels peaceful for me. I feel happy to be having that conversation.
What are your parents like? Are they like you? Are they not like you, but do they mm-hmm. embrace his philosophy as well?
Well, you know what? Actually, my parents are out of the body. I still talk to them though, but they're not in the body anymore. They're my ancestors now. So they kind of speak to me from a different place, you know? And my father was a Pentecostal pastor that was, I consider, my first guru. You know, he taught me to surrender to God, and he would be very, I think right now I can feel his presence, that he is very excited about the knowledge that I've come into within my heart and the allowance and the acceptance of the truth. So he was not like, he was not saying it this way, but he was saying it, you know, he wasn't saying it the way that I say it, but he was saying it. And, yeah, I feel like my mom is just helping me to, you know, keep honey on my lips, be sweet, and, you know, always have time to talk about this conversation right now, what we're talking about. So, yeah, that's kind of how I roll right now. That's how I'm rolling.